Accordion menus are used all over the internet. They are very useful to display either FAQs, subtabs, or anything else, and they are not very hard to reproduce, especially on Bubble. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an FAQ section like this one on Bubble, and after that, you'll be able to create any type of accordion menu in Bubble. Alright, so to save some time, I'm going to use an FAQ component from NoCodable Components library. This way, we don't have to design it all the way from scratch, and then we'll be able to see how it is built. So let's go ahead, let's copy it, and then we'll paste it. And if you want to try out NoCodable Components, you'll find the link in the description of this video. Alright, so let's take a look at how this FAQ section is built on Bubble. So as we can see, we have a main group called Group FAQ, which is our wrapper, and then we have a simple title for the section, and then we have a subgroup with a repeating group inside of it. But we'll come back to this later in the video. Let's take a look at how it is built now. So as we can see, in our repeating group, we have a main group called Question1, but we can call it just Question if we want, and this group is containing a group called Question plus icon, because we have a plus icon here, and then we have a group Answer just below the first group. So they are stacked vertically because our group question is obviously set to a layout of colon. Now, one more interesting thing to note is that the group answer is hidden on the page by default. You can see that the element is visible on page load is unchecked. And also, we have checked the box collapse when hidden to make sure it doesn't take any space when it is hidden in the space. And we also checked the animate the collapse operation and we set it to slide up down, but you can choose whatever you like. So basically, that's how you set up and how you structure an accordion menu. You have a first group that is always visible, that is in this case the question, and then when you will click on this group, it will make the subgroup, which is in this case the group answer, it will make it visible, it will toggle it. Alright, so now that we have the basic structure and the design of our FAQ section, we need to actually build it and actually make it dynamic. So by default, since we took this component from the codable components, we have some dummy data that is being injected in the repeating group, but we're going to change it and make it with our own data. We also have some workflows that are here and are already working, so we are going to delete that and we'll make it from scratch again just a bit later. So let's start with our data. We're going to go in the database and we're going to create a new data type that we're going to call FAQ. So in your database, create a new data type, call it FAQ. And as you can see earlier, we had an answer and a question for each FAQ. So we are going to create two fields, one which is going to be the question, field type the text, we only have one question per record, and then we have obviously the answer to this question, which is also a text, and we have only one in this case. If you have multiple responses, you can set it to a list and then display multiple answers. But we are not going to do that currently. Okay, so now we are going to create some dummy data to make sure we have something to display in our repeating group. So we can create question one, for example, then we'll have answer one. Okay, I'm going to create some other dummy FAQs and then we're going to type out the video. All right, so before looking at the preview, we need to make sure of one thing is that the data is going from the repeating group all the way down to our text, and that it goes through every group without any issue. So, since we copied this component from the NoCodable Components library, we have a bit of changes to make sure to adapt it to our own data. So, as we can see, if I go into the group question, we still have a type of content text, which is not what we want. We want a type of content FAQ, so we can change that. And now, if we go all the way down to the group, we can see that here I still have text, so I don't want that. I want to display an FAQ and I want to display only the parent group FAQ. Okay, and now into my text, I want to display a text, which is the parent group FAQ question. And there we go. Now our data is going all the way through from the repeating group itself to the text that display the question. We need to make the same thing for the answer, parent group answer, which is the type FAQ, because we're in the group, not in the text, parent group FAQ, and then parent group FAQ, and this is the answer. Once again, this group is hidden by default. As you can see, the element is visible on page load is unchecked, and we have the collapse to hidden, collapse when hidden, that is checked, and same, the animate the collapse operation, which is set to slide up down, so that when it shows, it has a neat little animation that slides up and down when it is hidden. All right, so let's take a look at how it looks. So as we can see, we already have question 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it seems to be okay. We don't have any issue in the app. The only thing that we're missing now is the workflow to actually show the group. So basically, what we need to do is that when we click on the parent group question, which is the group question, the one that contains the question, we want to make the group answer visible, because by default, just remember, it is hidden. It will be like that. So what we can do is simply go to our group question, add a workflow, and add an action called toggle an element. And then what are we going to toggle? We're going to toggle our group answer. And then we are good to go. And since we use the action toggle, when the group is not visible, it will be made visible. And when it is already visible, it will be hidden. So now we can take a look at the preview with the workflow. And as we can see, now my cursor has changed because I added the workflow to the group. And if I click on it, it shows the answer. And if I click again on it, it hides it. And same for the other. And there you go, that's basically how you create an accordion menu. You can do that for every type of accordion menu, whether it is for subtabs in a sidebar, FAQs, or any other thing that you want to do in Bubble. You now know how to do it. Don't forget to subscribe to like this video, and if you want to try out no-codable components, feel free to go in the description of the video.